Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, good morning.
There's your cat again.
Yes.
Guess you're going to see Russell's dog do that.
Every time I sit down here by my computer, the cat's up here with me.
Missy, when's your first day of school?
Teachers go back tomorrow. Kids come in, I guess, a week from Thursday.
So normally you'd be setting up a classroom.
They've been working on it, and we're setting up an outdoor classroom.
Good morning, Philip.
Good morning, everybody.
We missed you last week, Philip.
I was running around, I'll tell you. I was trying to imagine what it would have been like to try to do this with a 4-year-old hyperactive kid running around in and out of doors and that kind of thing. So I remember what it was like to be a parent.
Uh-huh. And glad those days are over.
Yes.
I love all of your illustrations.
Is there a story, Philip, about your Kennedy poster?
Well, only that it or a predecessor identical to it has been on my walls since 1960. Mm-hmm. That would be the story. And I lost it, the one that was actually used during the campaign, sometime over the years, but I picked up another one at the Kennedy Library that was identical and was tentative about 25 years ago and more to see how welcomed it would be in a Cuban household. but Abuela accepted it quickly. And I, mm-hmm. as long as it was kind of out of sight, it was in the stairwell, so I could see it every time I went downstairs to do the laundry.
Mm-hmm.
And now I have it in my drawing room, which is literally where I draw.
There's a joke about how King George III had a portrait of George Washington that he put in a inappropriate place.
Yes, I remember that.
I don't think we can share that now.
Well, it had a diuretic effect on him.
Pretty good. You did it.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
How am I? You're connected.
Good morning.
Kay and I are on the phone.
Good morning, Kay.
Okay.
Morning, Pastor.
How you doing?
Good, thanks. On this beautiful morning, what else?
So you got your power back, you got your phone back.
The key here.
Oh, yes.
So Bill and Margaret, how you doing? Morning, Claudia.
Yes.
Morning, how are you?
I'm not here.
How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
How are your grandchildren?
They're also wonderful, all of them.
What are their plans for school now?
They're going back on the 9th.
High school.
Mm-hmm. High school, they're both in high school.
Yeah.
And our granddaughter is back at college at Georgetown.
Okay. So Cecilia is on her way up to Boston today, I guess, right?
Oh, that's right. Today's the day.
Yeah.
All right.
So Kara's going up either Tuesday or Wednesday. She's not sure. I see Naki.
I'm here.
How you doing?
Good, thank you. How is everyone?
Everyone's good.
Hi, Naki.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing dishes from breakfast and cooking, so it's like I should probably prepping lunch already. So I should probably get off video.
Oh, Max.
Oh my God, what happened?
Happened to what? We can hear you, Ma. You okay?
My picture disappeared. Oh my God.
Lots of prayers at the Charlesville household.
That's right.
Good morning, Reverend Stephanie.
Good morning. I'm so sorry. I'm having technical difficulties over here.
Well, it's 7 a.m. for you, so you're allowed to have some. Yeah.
Stephanie.
Hello, Russell. Hello.
Cuz.
Good. How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
Hi, Stephanie.
Hi, Anita.
I'm having technical difficulties too. I don't know what happened.
Your screen's blank.
It went blank, and then it says join a meeting.
We and can see you though.
You can?
You're in our meeting.
Well, how come I can?
You must have jiggled the wire loose on your monitor or something.
I think something like that. I'm always having that kind of problem.
Your camera's working.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. I see Leslie.
Morning.
Good morning, Leslie. How are you doing?
Okay, thanks.
Pastor Stephanie, do you want to do any singing this morning? I actually have a video of you singing.
Yeah, let's use the video.
Okay, so we'll do that. So we'll get to hear Reverend Stephanie from her voice at 3 o'clock in the afternoon instead of her voice at 7 a.m.
Probably much better.
This week's candle is given by Lowell to the glory of God and in memory of his parents, Gustav and Margaret. Thanks be to God.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose steadfast love is everlasting, whose faithfulness endures from generation to generation.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
So the Kyrie today is going to be Anita as number one, Barbara as number two, and Lorna as number three. And the bold portions that are labeled all are going to be Philip.
We call upon our God.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
Our cry is God's Spirit interceding.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
We are the apple of God's eye.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
We are light and salt.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
God leads us and guides us.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
We are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
God died on a cross for us.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
God is our advocate, our very present help.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
God covers us under her wings.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
Nothing can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus.
Have mercy on me, O Lord.
God has a plan for each of us. We have been given a ministry of reconciliation.
Send us, O Lord.
We are ambassadors for Christ.
Send us, O Lord.
We are a beloved people, a royal, holy priesthood.
Send us, O Lord.
Let us pray. Giving thanks for all who have gone before us and are at rest, rejoicing in the communion of all the saints, we commend ourselves, one another, and our whole life to you, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
You, O Lord.
Philip, did I ask you if you want to do the prayer of the day?
Okay.
I don't think I asked you, but I'm asking you now.
Okay. Let us pray. Loving God, too often we feel unworthy to come before you. We are intimidated by your perfect goodness and holiness. Thank you for your Holy Spirit, which enables us to bask in holiness and feel the grace of your forgiving love. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah, the 58th chapter. Many congregations invest time and even money in defining an identity and developing a mission and vision statement. But our scripture has already given us a mission. Address injustice, free the oppressed, clothe the naked, shelter the homeless, and share your bread with the hungry. The prophet writes, "Such fasting as you do today will not make your voice heard on high. Is such the fast that I choose, a day to humble oneself? Is it to bow down the head like a bulrush and to lie in sackcloth and ashes? Will you call this a fast, a day acceptable to the Lord? Is not this the fast that I choose, to loose the bonds of injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover them and not to hide yourself from your own kin. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring up quickly. Your vindicator shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, 'Here I am.'" Holy wisdom, holy word.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. give thanks, because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because he's given Jesus Christ, his Son. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us. And now let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, because of what the Lord has done for us.
Give thanks. The good news according to Luke, the 11th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. This week we focus on the third verse of the prayer Jesus gave us. We ask our Lord for bread, for our bread, to make us a community that shares. Luke writes, Jesus said to them, when you pray, say, Father, hallowed be your name. The kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone indebted to us. And do not bring us to the time of trial. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
So we find ourselves watching the news from Wisconsin, and you know, just once again seeing the violence play out, and you know, seeing police who are using, I mean, I don't know what kind of judgment we can even call what the police did to Jacob Blake. It's just horrendous. Yesterday was kind of an uplifting day if you got to watch any of the speeches from Washington. And there was also the National Black Convention. My son shared that with me, so I was watching that. So I feel like we've been spending so much time this summer. I've spent a lot of time in very uncomfortable conversations trying to get people to understand what the protests are about. There are so many people who just don't understand the protests. They malign the protests. They see the athletes who are protesting and they say, you know, that they don't like the athletes doing that. So it's been really difficult trying to talk to people and try to figure out how to make them understand what's happening, what the protests are about.
Discrimination has not gone because people do not see other groups in the same way they see their own advantage, right? And so anything that keeps folks living the way that they feel is best for them, comfortable, is the way they want to keep living. And so, you know, I think the Isaiah text goes so well with the Luke text. Because what are we really doing here? You know, Isaiah is talking to the people about, what are you really fasting for? What is this fast for? You know, it is not about freeing the oppressed, giving liberty to the people. If it's not about taking care of humanity, then what is the point? Why are we really here? And so that piece about give us our daily bread. You know, I think, you know, bread is used because it's sustenance for life. What's the point of giving folks bread if you don't care if they live or die? I mean, if we go back to the Civil Rights Movement, how many people were against the Civil Rights Movement until they witnessed what happened on the bridge in Alabama. Mm-hmm. The Pettus Bridge. If they didn't see what happened on that bridge, would there have been such a civil rights movement in the city? And even go further, if the white minister was not killed by the racist white supremacists of the South, mm-hmm. would there be a civil rights act that was signed in 1965? Right? And so it comes down to humanity. You know, the ministers that wrote the letter to Martin Luther King, telling him, oh, you gotta take it slow, oh, you gotta, you know, you shouldn't protest. And that letter from the Birmingham jail that made it clear that God requires us to care for the people, and now is the time. You can't be okay with people dying. And so racism is destructive, not just to black and brown people. It's destructive to the whole society of humanity, because when you develop a system of privilege and power, there are always going to be people who fall through the cracks, right? This is why I love the Luke gospel, because the Luke gospel makes room for everybody, the rich, the poor, the woman, the man, the children, everybody, the old, the young. There was room for everybody in the Luke gospel. And he said, because Luke was a man of means, right? That's what they believe, that the writer of Luke was a man of means. So I'm a woman, I'm a person. And so, you know, I have to look at the humanity of people and say, is there something wrong here? Same thing with the LGBTQ. Where is the humanity of people? And then we have to look at the Bible. Jesus told us to love and see love. That was his last commandment to the people. And Jesus loved the people. He was here to liberate and free the people. So, you know, if my comfort trumps my faith, then I don't really have faith. Let's just be clear. Faith is our word today. Mm-hmm. Because something in you says that humanity matters. Humanity matters. We have to have faith that if we live as Christ, as God has told us to live, that we will have our daily bread. We won't be without it. We've got to trust that he will give us our daily bread.
When I think about racism, I mean, there's a couple of things that, just to go back over what we've basically been saying, which is that, you know, it's not rational, racism, right? So. There's a way in which white people don't understand the way in which they're injuring themselves. And then just the whole capacity of people to deny that racism exists, to deflect from racist attacks to the protesters are being, you know, are going too far. And, you know, the protesters are being violent or they're looting, you know, that becomes the narrative to say that the protests are a problem, and to miss, you know, what just happened, and for, you know, like you say, the letter from a Birmingham jail was that the ministers were criticizing him in his protests because they can't see what the protesters are trying to point them towards. So there's just something, I think James Baldwin writes a lot about the way in which Americans just deny what they're doing. Just this capacity to go on, you know, with this system that's violent and that's destructive, and to deny that it's actually happening. So I wish we could
figure out. To deny that it injures white people just as much.
Yeah.
The system is not helping anybody. If COVID-19 has not shown us that, it's not helping anybody.
Yeah.
It's about the total humanity of people, which is what God requires. It's from the beginning, from Genesis. All the way to Revelation, the humanity of folks, that we care for one another and have the faith to love one another, to love humanity. That's that.
So racism denies its own existence. people know that there was horrible racism in the past.
Mm-hmm.
Not going to argue that, you know, I mean, there are some people, but most people are not going to argue that slavery was good. Most people are not going to argue that, you know, segregating lunch counters was good.
Mm-hmm.
So I keep trying to get them to understand that the reason for slavery, the reason for discrimination and segregation was because preachers were explaining that it was good. Preachers were getting up and saying, slavery is the best for everybody. It really is.
That's right.
So I keep thinking, just to get people to realize that that whole structure of racism that we know was horrible and oppressive and violent then, you know, didn't go away. You know, there's no way in which all those people just stopped feeling that way. Those people, you know, who wanted to bomb that church in Alabama and kill 400 kids.
That's right. Yeah,
those people had that mindset that told them that that was what they needed to do. I mean, they're almost like jihadis or something, you know, where, you know, killing innocent people, blowing up a house of worship is justified, it makes sense. So if there's some way to get people to, you know, to stop that disconnect between the racism of the past, you know, as if that's something that could have ended. Because they say that, oh, that's the past, don't keep bringing that up because that's over. But so I don't know how to get people to understand that it couldn't just end in a day. And if it's something that self-perpetuates itself, you know, from generation.
Right, it's all economically based, right?
Mm.
And so we can go back to the Bible. Jesus has to come, not just so that sick people can walk again and blind people can see again. He has to come because there is a system that is economically oppressing the people. But this is what you got to tell the truth, that it's economic.
Mm-hmm. I think Luther does a good job of focusing on our daily bread as being an economic system. That our daily bread means that people are going to be fed and not going to be, you know, mistreated. I was reading this book, Forgotten Luther, Reclaiming the Socioeconomic Dimension of the Reformation, because it looks at a lot of the ways in which the whole premise of grace in the Reformation was saying that it's not about rich and powerful people, it's not about, you know, our own abilities or our merit. It's about God's gift and God's freely given gift. So that Luther had a really sharp economic critique. He talked about how the vendors in the market would say, I can sell my goods for as much as I can get. And that's their law.
Mm-hmm.
And Luther said, you know, shouldn't it be, I can sell my goods for what I ought to sell it for, or what would be fair and reasonable. So Luther saw the economic excessiveness. And of course, it came into the church when they started selling indulgences. So here they are selling a fictitious product. They're saying, here's your soul, I'm going to sell you your soul for a certain amount of money. So it's natural that Luther had this economic critique. So the effect of Luther's idea of grace was to show that the medieval notion that resources were being given to the wealthy by God, resources were being kept from the poor by God, resources were being taken away from the poor by God was a lie. So at the just the center of grace took away this notion that the status quo is what God wanted. The status quo kind of reflected God's ideas. So the doctrine of the free gift of God's love destroys a foundation for a society that justifies inequality, that justifies discrimination. So when you have a society that says, things are good, this is the best for everybody, don't mess with it, and then a doctrine of grace comes in and says, you know, this is not the way God wants things. And God doesn't want us to make it all about ourselves and the way in which we can make the world for our comfort, for our comfort, as you talk about there. So there's a way in which, you know, the idea of grace takes us out of the center of things and puts God in the center of things.
Right.
And reorders our way of looking at human structure. So I found this book to be very good. It's very thin. And there's just not a lot on the way in which Luther, you know, critiques economics.
Right.
And so Luther really focused on this idea, our daily bread. When you read our daily bread, when you pray those words, our daily bread, you should be thinking about anybody who's hungry.
Anybody.
Our daily bread is for us, all of us, to be eating and for all of us to be taken care of. And so I paired it together with the Isaiah text to say, you know, the fast that God wants is for you to share your bread with the hungry. Because Luke is just imbued with Isaiah. And Isaiah talks about, you know, people who are called evil good and called good evil. Mm-hmm. You know, and that's a lot of what racism is. It just says white people are good because they're white. And black people are criminals because they're black. And, you know, gay people are degenerates because they're gay. And Native Americans are savages because they're Native Americans. And, you know, immigrants from Central America are lazy because they're immigrants from Central America. This idea that, you know, defines people as good or evil is reversing things and distorting things from a human-centered focus.
Well, you know, I always say, you know, people celebrate that the church converted Constantine, but I feel that Constantine converted the church.
Yeah.
And so, you know, when you try to use God to justify, like, as just what you're saying, to justify being inhumane, that's just evil, because that's not what God is about. It's 2020, and we're experiencing it because people can't see my humanity. And so suppose I let the hate of racism turn me into something else. You know what I mean? Turn me into something else.
Yeah.
And so I can't say, oh, I'm just going to treat those white people the way they treat me.
Yeah.
Not if I've got faith in God. It doesn't make sense.
So I'm grateful for Luther for, you know, focusing on these three words and saying, you know, anytime you're thinking about your belly and saying, you know, I need my bread and you want to grab your bread and run, remember that Jesus told us to pray for our bread.
Our bread.
And that we're praying to our Father because we're supposed to be gathering and supporting each other.
Our bread.
Yeah.
You can't be okay with people being hungry. Bread. You can't be okay with people being killed. Our bread. People are trying to live. Bread is for life.
Yeah.
Our
bread. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Pastor Jim.
For a great blessing. You brought a great blessing to me today.
Thank you. Yeah.
So I'm going to make two versions of this. I'm going to make an edited version that I'll drop into the worship service.
Okay.
And then I'll tell people there's a full version. I'm not sure how long we went on, but there'll be I think all of that was good, and I want to post that.
Okay.
But also do a shorter version for worship. Very good.
Thank you, Gary.
Thank you so much.
All right.
All right, have a good day.
You too.
Joyful, joyful, we adore thee, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like clouds before thee, praising thee, their Son above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the gloom of doubt away. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of day. All thy works with joy surround thee, earth and heaven reflect thy rays, stars and angels sing around thee, center of unbroken praise. Field and forest, vale and mountain, flowery meadow, flashing sea, chanting bird and flowing fountain, call us to rejoice in thee. Thou art giving and forgiving, ever blessing, ever blessed, wellspring of the joy of living, ocean depth of happy rest. Though our Father, Christ our brother, all who live in love are not, Teach us how to love each other. Lift us to the joy divine.
Everyone can hear me? So we continue now with the prayers of the people. Let us pray with one voice, listen for the Spirit, and open our hearts.
God of hope.
Just to turn your volume.
God of holiness, help us to spread your love upon this world. In this time of global distress, send your healing power to healthcare workers and first responders. As we pray for all working and essential jobs, help us to hear and support them in their needs. As we wait, many of us alone in our homes, remind us that calling, writing, and praying for each other and those in need is your work in our hands. Help us to trust in your help to be your church in such a time as this. God of love, hear our prayer.
So, Naki, you have to unmute yourself.
Holy Wisdom, bless all teachers and students, our Sunday school, and all parents who are juggling work and childcare. Help us to nurture young minds with critical thought and young hearts with empathy and curiosity. Bless our bishops, Paul and Elizabeth. Bless church service programs, schools, hospitals, social service organizations, advocacy groups, universities, and nursing homes. Bless our child care center, its staff, advisory committee, and families. We thank you for this vital mission to and with our community. May we each discover how the talents that you have graced us with can be used to your glory. God of joy,
hear our prayer.
God of creation, you called everything into being. Sustain this world with your renewing care. We pray for all the victims of hurricanes, storms, and wildfires. Help us to meet the needs of others and instill in us a deeper wonder for the created world you've called good. May we generously share the abundance of your world. God of wholeness, hear our prayer. God of care, you created us in your image. We are your beloved children. May we recognize your likeness in one another. Open our eyes to the sin of racism as it does daily harm and fractures our relationships. Help us repent and begin to repair the damage and to be your ministers of reconciliation. Protect vulnerable children and adults. Help us to respond to victims of gun violence, including Jacob Blake. Guide us in providing what is needed for those lacking. God of justice, hear our prayer.
We pray as a community that shares each other's blessings and burdens. We bring our prayer concerns together as we lift up Marek, Myrtle, Harriet, Pam, Bill, Jamie, Emmett, Anilda, Guilherme, the Habina family, Claudette, Dylan, Carlene, Michael, Marge, Brigitte, Barbara, Diane, Tessa, Thaddeus, Sandy, Yvonne, Susie, Christina, David, Olivia, William, Nancy, Patricia, Alexander, Peter, God of hope, hear our prayer. Create in our hearts a yearning to rest in your promise of eternal and resurrected life. Give us thankful hearts for those who have died, even as we look forward to the hope of new life in you. Bless all those who mourn the loss of loved ones, especially the families of Edward Coombs, Paula Blanco, Wen Shuhuang, Roger Ferguson, Sharon Nearby, Georgiana Church Broadway, Christina Pucci, Connie Lockwood, and Kathleen Radigan. Bless those celebrating birthdays, especially Linda, Dave, Bill, Evan, and Philip. God of mercy, hear our prayer. O God, receive these prayers and the prayers of our hearts through the power of the Spirit, in Jesus' name, amen.
Hi, Max.
Hi, Max.
Hey, hello.
So, Pam, you volunteered to do something?
Yep.
You want to do the offering information?
Sure.
On page 12?
Okay.
Does someone want to do the offering options?
That's not for me.
Cecilia, did you want to do something?
Could do this already if nobody wants to do it.
Okay. Does nobody want to do it? The peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ be with us all.
And also with you.
The sign is peace with you.
So this is supposed to be becoming. It's one thing becoming another. And then this is calm. And they put those two words together to be becoming calm. And then with is pretty clear, right? And you is pretty clear. And who's going to give us the offering description?
That would be me. I just want to thank everyone during this time as we're having these really lovely Sunday mornings together in a new fashion. Thank you for continuing to contribute to the church.
Good morning, everyone.
Thank you to all who have sent your donations during the pause.
We want to thank you, especially in this time of separation when so many needs continue, for the generosity that so many of you and so many of us have continued in supporting the ministry and outreach of St. Paul's Evangelical Lutheran Church.
Offerings are still very much encouraged and welcomed and thanked for, and for those who continue to join us every Sunday for these wonderful Zoom gatherings,
for their faithful donations and keeping up with their pledges and offerings. Just share again with you that there are several ways that you can send in your offering while we're still not back at church. First is you can just send it in by mail. Include your envelopes. If you don't have your envelopes, it's fine. You can have a record of it and just mail it in. You can also contact your bank and ask them to send in a check of whatever amount and frequency that you choose.
To the church at 761 King Street. Now, if you're a little tech here, quick pay with Zelle. Most banks do have Zelle. So just log on and find St. Paul's at Donna's email address, which is spelch@msn.com, and you can send in your weekly offering that way. And for those who are truly, truly tech advantaged, Venmo.com or the Venmo app, if you search out St. Paul's-Rybrook, you're going to see Laura's name pop up, but that also just provides a direct transfer right into our accounts. So any of those ways are very appreciated, and we thank you for continuing to contribute to the health of the church and for being here every week.
thank you for your generosity, and we continue to pray together and unite together to continue the ministries of this church. Thank you.
Thank you all so much for continuing to give and continuing to join these beautiful Sundays.
Let us pray.
Good and loving God, we rejoice in the life of Jesus, who came among the poor to bring the riches of your grace.
As you have blessed us with your gifts, let them be a blessing for others.
With all creation, we offer our praise and thanks to you always and everywhere.
To your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
God of hope, faith, and love.
Amen.
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 Let us pray. Dear God and Father, creator of all, help us to see our community of creation, to see you as Father and we as your people. Holy be your name. Form us to be an image of your grace. Give us this day our daily bread. May we strive for a humanity where there are no poor among us. Help us to be humbled by your grace and renewed by your forgiveness, to be a community forgiven and forgiving. Save us from trials and temptations. Strengthen us by your holy word and by prayer and study. Almighty God, may we seek your kingdom, search for your presence, and pray for your reign to take root in our lives. Your kingdom come. Help us to understand power and glory as your word, as you would have us understand them and live by them. And Lord, help us to pray together, and we thank you that you gave us words, and so we pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. So let us pray for God's blessing. May the Lord bless us and keep us. May the Lord's face shine upon us and be gracious to us. May the Lord look upon us in mercy and grant us peace. Amen. I'm going to unmute everybody. I'm going to invite everybody to unmute themselves. Anybody have any prayer concerns that they want to share? Anyone want to give us an update about someone that we have on our prayer list? Kirsten was telling me that Thaddeus is doing very well, so we're glad and we continue to pray for him. And Patty had something she wanted to share?
So, three things, actually, brief. Number one, thank you, Stephanie. That was a wonderful, joining in singing and the sermon, too. Secondly, sorry, Noki, if I jumped in on your, on the part of the-
Not at all. I was trying to unmute myself and I couldn't, and thank you. Not at all.
The third one is I'm going to ask everybody to pray for me this week because I go back to school and it's completely remote this week, and next week it's going to be hybrid, but everything is in the language of technology, and that is not, you know, what I am signed up for, and I think my age works against me in that, not having grown up with it. So I ask everybody to bring prayers for support for probably for all the teachers, but this week is going to be challenging.
I know how you feel. I've said a couple of times now that I did not sign up to be a televangelist or a video editor or all the things that are taking up all my time now.
Yeah, yeah. It's true. We'll keep our prayers for you too then, Pastor.
Yeah, we've gotten better at it. We've grown into it.
Yeah.
I mean, when I think, Anita, you didn't even have email a year ago. And now you're on Zoom every week, and you just leapt over all of that technology of the late 20th century into the 21st century.
Somewhat.
Well, last week I couldn't get the microphone to work. The last 2 weeks I couldn't get the microphone to work. If I didn't have Liam here, we'd not be getting any of this done. Is that Linda?
Yes, it is.
Linda, first time viewer.
Yay! Now, if I can figure it out on time next week, I'll be done.
Well, some of us are in different time zones. Stephanie, it's like, what is it, 8 o'clock now, Stephanie?
Minutes to 8 here in Las Vegas, minutes to 8.
And they haven't gone to bed yet, right? They've been up all night?
It feels like it, but...
The casinos, people just stay up all night, right?
Well, you know, it's funny, since the pandemic, the strip was closed down, but now it's reopening.
Mm.
So we've got people coming from different places because there's not too many places to vacation. And so people are coming. I stay in the house, but you know, it's all good. Yeah. And I just want to say I'm so thankful to be with St. Paul this morning, even though it was a little struggle, but I'm glad to be here and to see everyone this morning. And yeah, I'm going to ask for prayer concern. If you could add my uncle Godwin Stevens to your prayer. He is in a rehabilitation center now in South Carolina. And so if you could add his name and also his wife, Victoria Stevens. She's in Florida doing well, but she's in Florida with, you know, they have to be separated for health concerns. And so if you could lift those two names, I'd greatly appreciate it.
Yes. And we thank you for getting up 3 hours earlier than the rest of us. And and you and I were on for an hour last night, and then you're back again today.
Right.
Yeah. So I mentioned at the end of the sermon discussion that I cut the time of that down by half, I think.
Yeah, I saw you did good. You did good.
I took out my whole sermon illustration about Will Smith.
Yeah, but I hope you left it in the bigger version.
So there's a longer version, which is, I guess, 30 minutes maybe, which also includes Stephanie's two songs that we heard today. So that's on YouTube if anyone wants to see the entire thing. And if you don't mind us getting a little more political than we did in the abbreviated version.
Yeah.
Hey, Linda, do you have any prayer concerns that you wanted to lift up today or any announcements?
I really, you have said something about taking people off the list. The Habina family can do that because everything's working well for them now.
Okay. So we say a prayer of thanks for that.
Yes. Yes, indeed.
Everything else is good with you?
I can't complain.
You can complain.
No, not really when you stop and think about it.
I give you permission to complain.
No. When you consider a lot of other people's situations, I'm sitting very nicely. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, I hope that helps you to frame your mind that way.
Well, occasionally.
Yeah. And anytime you want to complain, you just call me up.
Oh my gosh. Oh, you're opening yourself up there.
Yeah. It's good to get those things out. You don't have to say that there are worse people than you and you can't complain. You can complain when you want to.
Well, thank you for the permission.
Sure.
Happy birthday, Linda.
Thank you. Thank you.
Philip.
I'm at the point where you know, you wake up on your birthday and you think, hey, I'm still here.
Amen.
We had a nice birthday yesterday with Lorna. We had her sisters came over and they made a nice Caribbean brunch for us.
I saw the pictures, what, Facebook?
Yeah, there was a Facebook picture.
No, I've heard some of those names or seen some of the names of the foods you had, and they sound intriguing.
So I wrote on the caption saltfish, and Liam corrected me. He said, it's not saltfish, it's saltfish. And I said, well, it's salted fish, and yeah, they say saltfish, but...
Okay.
T is silent in the Caribbean. That's
yeah.
right.
Yeah, so he had heard that and he picked up on it.
Max cooks on Friday night too.
Now I gotta go find some and cook some now. Now you got me.
We had some ackee and we had some callaloo and some banana bread that was what did you say the banana bread was, Lauren? It was vegan banana bread?
Yes, it was vegan.
And it was delicious banana bread. I might not have eaten it if she told me that, but I ate it and then she told me and it was really good.
Tell me, what is ackee?
It's a fruit that grows on trees. Do you want to tell her about the fruit of ackee?
Ackee is the national fruit of Jamaica.
Ah.
It's a fruit, actually. It's spelled A-C-K-E-E. It looks like scrambled eggs when it's done, but it tastes nothing like that. It has a unique taste. And this is the part that I love to tell. It can actually be poisonous if it's not prepared the right way.
Oh, like, wow. Yeah, fugu or fuju, Japanese fish.
It's grown all over the Caribbean, but I think Jamaicans are the only ones to eat it. And it's actually our national dish, so...
Mm-hmm.
Let me say something about our character.
Thank you.
Other countries won't touch it, right?
Yeah.
They leave it rotting on the ground. Anybody else have any updates? So, Naki, the boys are getting ready to go back to school, right?
They are. It's a stressful one.
Mm.
We're getting back in person 2 days a week, and then remotely the rest of the week. Mm. So we just hope it's going to be a safe one.
Yeah.
What grades are they in?
They're both going to be in middle school this year. We're going to have a seventh grader and a sixth grader. Yes.
Wow.
Now, do they have to wear masks at school?
They do. They have to wear masks the entire time. They get mask breaks. It's going to be interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
My niece goes to school here in Nevada. She goes to private school, so they have resumed in-room classrooms. And she wears a face shield. She wears a regular mask over her nose and mouth. But she also wears a face shield.
Are they doing any remote?
Not the public schools here in Nevada are doing remote learning. And so we were concerned. I was a little worried myself, still worried, but the school is taking many precautions. And we've been teaching Angelique, that's my niece, what she has to do to stay safe. And you pray for the school systems here. You know, the economy here is not that great, so they weren't able to get Chromebooks to every student.
Mm.
A lot of students don't have access to internet, so it's real challenging what's going on now.
Well, if you live in a city that has an economy that's based on tourism.
Right. Exactly.
You're really in a bad place at a time like this, right? On the back of our bulletin with the prayer list is the list of the states that are to be considered states that you need to be quarantining if you've come to New York from any of those states. So that's a good thing to put on your prayer list is states that are experiencing an increase. Nevada's on there.
Yes, it is. And also the Virgin Islands. Say a prayer for the Virgin Islands. They're on the list.
Yeah, we have that on our list here. They've had one of the biggest increases, I think, yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And the same thing, it's the tourism, because it's because you can't close the borders of the Virgin Islands because of the U.S. borders.
Mm.
The people just keep coming.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, it's rough.
Mm-hmm.
It's rough.
Okay.
Whatever happened to the concept of the common good?
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And we want to thank Philip for the beautiful cover art that we've had. I really like the ones that he's been doing for the Lord's Prayer. And Philip's been helping with the prayer of the day. We didn't have prayers of the day, and we needed them crafted, so he did the prayer of the day. So we've really been very blessed with our deacon intern, all the help that he's been doing. And if anyone is sick and wants a visit, you can call me, you can call Philip, and we can visit you on your patio, we can visit you on your driveway, we can visit you, Linda, we can come and we can come onto your balcony and we can wave to you. And so if anyone wants to visit and we just figure out a way to do it outside, that's great. And if people want to come by here, I've been glad that I've been able to have Bible study and knitting so that we get to see some people we don't see on Zoom. Okay. Well, I want to tell everybody to stay safe this week.
You too.
And have a safe trip home.
Peace and love, everybody.
Yes. Thank you, everybody.
Take care.
Thank you.
Take care. Bye-bye.